In the greater community, life force is a power that is used. It can have great influence over the unknowing. Its equivalent in the mental environment is the power of projected forms of thought. In the physical environment, life force exerts an actual force that moves things and creates an impact and a reaction. Someone can knock you down with life force even if they are standing across the room. Someone can weaken you physically using life force even if they are across the street. Life force is not as effective in the physical environment as it is in the mental environment, where thoughts can be directed at an individual thousands, even millions, of miles away and have an impact. This is true because in the mental environment there is no resistance except the resistance of countering ideas. In the physical environment, there is a great deal of resistance, such as the resistance encountered by a moving object. In the mental environment, there is nothing that affects the velocity of a moving thought except a countering thought. And a countering thought must be born of a mind that is aware of what is impacting it and can arouse within itself power in the mental environment to counter, obstruct or prevent the accelerating thought from reaching it. We call this mental screening. It is a great ability. You cannot use this ability constructively unless you are selected by the wise and prepare for a very long time. You must begin to learn about life force now because it represents part of what affects you individually and what shapes your world. As greater community influences gain a greater stronghold in your world, their abilities, their power and their awareness will exert an ever greater impact on all aspects of your life. Some of these are very manifest, but many are quite subtle. Often they cannot be seen. However, they can be discerned because you can feel them. Why is this important in the context of spirituality? Because it represents the world into which the Creator has sent you. Given a real understanding of your purpose and a real experience of its meaning, you will see that everything fits within this theological context because of the nature of your origin and your destiny, where you have come from and where you are going. The world is a place that you are in temporarily. Therefore, where you have come from and where you are going provide the real meaning of your existence here. Life force is power that few have ever discovered and fewer still have ever learned to use constructively. There are those in the greater community who can use it in certain situations, but this does not mean that they can control it. There is a very great difference between use and control. For example, you use electricity, but the ability to control it, redirect it and guide it represents a greater set of skills and abilities. You use the power of the sun to grow food. But can you harness the power of the sun? Can you control it? Let us give you this understanding. No one in physical life can control the mechanism of the universe. No one in physical life can control time. They can use time, but they cannot fully control it. The wise know the limits of control and exercise their abilities appropriately. The foolish think that there are no limits, that everything is there for them to acquire, to conquer or to obtain. No one individual or group of individuals can gain control of the physical universe because everyone exists within limits. It may appear that you have great power and ability compared to other people. However, seen in a larger context, you have significant limits. Knowing your limits represents an aspect of wisdom. Knowing what you can develop and what is beyond your reach represents an aspect of wisdom. These are learned as you proceed in the way of knowledge because here you are beginning to distinguish greater powers from lesser powers. You cannot control knowledge, the knowing mind within you. You cannot direct it to give you what you want. You cannot focus it to produce the results you want. You cannot use it to influence others. Why? Because it is more powerful than you are. You can enter into relationship with it. You can reclaim it in your awareness. You can learn to reassociate with it by taking the steps to knowledge, but you cannot control it. You can only control your expression of it, and this is within your range of responsibility. However, do not think for a moment that this is a small responsibility. It is actually very great and represents consummate learning in the human environment. It is an interesting fact of life in the greater community that the wise are all very similar, and the unwise are all very different from each other. The wise from your world and the wise from other worlds have so much in common. However, the unwise are so distinct. The wise in all worlds have a means of communicating with each other through knowledge, yet the unwise cannot recognize or communicate with each other. The wise see what is the same. The unwise see what is different. The wise identify with what is the same. The unwise identify with what is different. In order for humanity to have any advantage in the greater community, certain individuals here must become wise within a larger context in life. And others must support these individuals, because for every individual that advances, it takes a great deal of support from others. This is how knowledge is kept alive in the world. And this provides a means for knowledge to be communicated in the world through a network of relationships, all supporting a central focus. This is how greater things are communicated throughout the greater community, throughout all manifest life, and indeed even beyond manifest life. Real wisdom is passed on through a network of relationships. Like water seeping downward through the soil, wisdom finds its real channels and its path of least resistance. It creates pathways where knowledge can be passed on, transmitted and initiated from person to person through a means that is both wonderful and mysterious. The pursuit of knowledge and wisdom is not an individual quest. It is a collective effort. For anyone to advance requires meaningful involvement with many other people. Developing this understanding indeed is part of the education of going from a singular approach to a community approach, going from a singular viewpoint of life to a greater community understanding of life. This is a part of your education. This is a part of the transition from being lost in your individuality to being embodied in the greater reality. Life force means something different at either end of the spectrum, and your understanding of it will change as you pass through the spectrum on the way to a greater reality. Indeed, all that we are presenting in greater community spirituality is important because it takes you to a greater reality. It cannot be used within an individual reality. The greater community way of knowledge invites you to find escape from your own isolation, escape from being lost in your own individuality, and escape from being a prisoner of your own mind. It invites you to rediscover your intrinsic relationship with all life and the specific purpose which is yours to reclaim and to contribute in this life, at this time, in this world. You will need life force to progress, to advance and to carry on your preparation and your contribution. The extent to which you will need to use it and how you will need to use it depends on the role that you are here to play. Your role here is predetermined, but how it will be carried out and the time it takes to carry it out, especially the time it takes to discover it and to prepare for it, can vary considerably. In this, your decision making has great importance, and indeed you will determine if the outcome can be achieved. What greater responsibility would you ever want to assume for yourself? People who think that they can create their own destiny and who call this their freedom have no idea of the burden that they are placing upon their own shoulders. This burden is great because it guarantees failure. You cannot control your greater destiny, but you can experience it, and you can find a way to express it. In this, you will have to make many decisions. In this, you will have to assume greater responsibilities. In this, you will find your power. And in this, you will assume authority in your life. You are the captain of your ship, but it is not up to you to determine where it is sailing and for what purpose. Even what your ship contains is beyond your authority. Consider these words carefully and do not make a mistake here. To become the captain of your ship is a responsibility and a power that few people have ever assumed. To become a true captain means that you are aware of everything concerning the protection, maintenance and well-being of your vessel, and that you have respect for its secret cargo and its true destiny. While many people proclaim that they are the captain of their own lives, they have no idea what this means. In the greater community, personal freedom has a different context and a different value. Advanced technological societies are highly organized. Individuals are not free to do whatever they please whenever they please without regard for others. The greater community is a competitive environment on a scale and a magnitude that you cannot even imagine. Therefore, to become effective and competitive in this environment, and, beyond this, to gain greater community knowledge and wisdom, you must over time reassess all of your values and assumptions. Personal freedom is chaos without knowledge. It is the source of everyone's mental and physical illness. Contrast will show you this as you learn to associate with those who are beginning to discover a greater purpose and meaning in life, and as you yourself begin your own discovery of this. The contrast will be marked. You will see yourself going in a different direction from everyone else. You will see yourself valuing experience more than ideas, insight more than assumptions, patience more than acquisition and affinity more than possessions. You will travel a different path, and the discrepancy between your growing understanding and the assumptions of your nation, of your culture, of your group and even of your family will become greater and greater. Such is the burden and the promise of discovering knowledge throughout the greater community. Life force is within you. You can feel it at this moment. It is breathing your body. It is moving your blood. It is keeping your nerves alive. It is sparking your mental awareness. It is here right now, and it will grow in scope, meaning and value for you as you progress in the way of knowledge. It will grow as you leave your ideas, beliefs and assumptions at the outer gate of the temple and enter in where true wisdom and knowledge can be imparted to you.